my mother name. What's up guys, KDub175 back with another Pokemon Duel video, and this video is going to be covering the Ultra Beast in Pokemon Duel. I want to take a look at some of the base stats of these Ultra Beasts, and then we already know what the wheels look like for the current Ultra Beast, but then we can do some theorizing and maybe anticipate what the wheels might look like on the next Ultra Beast that are still yet to drop. And we already know that they come from Ultra Space. They basically possess more power than the world has ever seen, some of the strongest Pokemon that the world has ever seen, right? And it looks like that they are releasing these Pokemon in order, Nihiligo being the first Ultra Beast that we got. And if we take a look at its EV yield, it has a 3 in special defense, and I believe the EV stands for effort value. And I believe, I don't understand it, you know, 100%. If any of you guys, you know, understand this a lot better than me, definitely let me know in the comments. I definitely want this video to encourage a lot of discussion between you guys interacting with each other and me. But it looks like whatever the highest EV yield is going to be, that's going to be its highest stat. That's what it's going to, you know, be. It's going to be strongest in that category. So special defense being Nihiligo's highest EV yield. I also want to take a look at the biology, guys, so we can understand what these Pokemon actually are, what they can do, and then what that might mean for Pokemon Duel and the figure and what it could mean for the game. So if you guys skip down to the second paragraph, Nihiligo is a parasitic organism and, by latching onto one's head, is capable of injecting a neurotoxin that subtly alters their thoughts and actions of any human or Pokemon that becomes its host. The neurotoxin stimulates intense feelings of excitement while causing a loss of inhibitions. So, like, we already know with the white tentacles, you are able to move the opponent's Pokemon. So that kind of, you know, translates from what the lore and background of these Pokemon and what they can do in the game. So it does kind of seem like, for the most part, Pokemon Duel tries to take the background and base stats of these Pokemon and implement it into the game. So if you take a look at these base stats, special defense is the highest, along with special attack and HP. Well, it has a nice purple, it has a ton of blue, and then even its white attack does have a gold attack for that one turn, and you're able to move the Pokemon around. So definitely some special attacks and defense with having a lot of blue, being able to call back other Pokemon from the Ultra Space. So just trying to show you guys that the background on these Pokemon and the base stats definitely translates into the game. So Buzzwole was the next Ultra Beast that we got. It has a 1 attack and 2 in defense for its EV values, which again, I believe means effort values. I'm not really sure how you train those or whatnot, but it definitely seems like that those are its strongest categories. So if you guys take a look and skip down to the bottom paragraph, its most notable feature is its ability to strengthen itself. By absorbing the energy of its foes, it triggers a chemical reaction within its body fluids that causes its muscles to grow at an explosive rate. So Buzzwole, he gets that buff every time there's a Pokemon in the Ultra Space. So if you have 1 Nihiligo or 2 Nihiligo, it's going to get that extra damage increase. So I feel like that's Pokemon Duel's way of incorporating this background in biology of that Pokemon. You know, it's not exact, but I mean, it's pretty close, right? So let's take a look at the base stats, all right? Its highest is defense and attack at a 139, and then its HP at 107. So I'm not really sure how Pokemon Duel incorporates HP, maybe by giving the Pokemon less miss, but it does have a lot of blue, and it's got some pretty heavy damaging white attacks, especially with the buff, running it with the Nihiligo. And when Nihiligo goes to the Ultra Space, for every Nihiligo, it's going to get that extra damage increase. So, looks pretty close, right? I would say Buzzwole is a strong representation of its base stats and background. Then we have the Pheromosa, which has been the third Ultra Beast and was released with Buzzwole. So I think we might get two Ultra Beasts next banner. But if you take a look at its EV yield, it has 3 in speed. And I have a feeling that special attack is like purple, you know, defense, special defense is with blue, you know, speed can be MP, sometimes even a gold attack. So, you know, HP is possibly how much miss it has, but let's take a look at the biology. So Pheromosa, it's basically capable of sudden feats of acceleration, able to twitch its limbs at an estimated 120 miles per hour instantaneously, a speed previously unseen in the world. Well, it's the first Pokemon that it's actually allowed to have 4 MP without a glitch, right? And then it's also says, if you scroll down a little bit further, it'll say that it also produces a sort of disarming pheromone, which was described as previously unknown to science, that causes those nearby to become awestruck. So it kind of has that low sweep that gives that minus 1 MP to a Pokemon. So I feel like that they're incorporating it pretty well. But if we take a look at the base stats, okay, so definitely speed is its highest attribute. Then it has special attack and then attack. So for how high these stats are, it is kind of a weak Pokemon. But with it being able to get up to 4 MP, I don't know. I mean, and then it has that ice punch that freezes the Pokemon, so that could maybe be considered a special attack. And plus it's blue being able to call back Pokemon from the Ultra Space. But I think attack is definitely represented by like heavy hitting white attacks, you know, where special attack is more of a purple, and maybe gold, you know, with speed, with the MP, maybe the gold. So, you know, I don't know. I feel like it could be a little stronger, but since it gets 4 MP, maybe that's why they didn't do it. But Zerkatry, this is a Pokemon that I'm definitely excited for, guys. Zerkatry is probably one of my favorite Ultra Beasts, but I will definitely let you know when we get to my favorite. It has 3 in special attack. So far, out of all the Ultra Beast Pokemon that we've got, this is the first one that's going to have a 3 in special attack for its EV yield. So let's take a quick look at its biology. So I want you guys to kind of scroll down on the first paragraph where it says, finally, its tail has 1 loose cable in 2 sections and ends in what resembles a 3-prong plug. With this, it plugs its tail into the ground when it uses electrical attacks. And it basically also says, if you go down even further, that it has an organ that's capable of producing over 1 million volts. You know, I definitely wouldn't want to be next to it. And then it's been reported that it's rated a power plant, and it's speculated to sustain itself with electricity. This is supported by observations that it will plug its limbs and tail into the ground when it's low on energy, entering a tree-like state to absorb electricity from the earth. So maybe this is going to be like a really good hard counter to Zapdos. Maybe it's not even going to be able to get knocked out by electric types. Maybe it's going to paralyze everything and have like an awesome purple that knocks Pokemon out. You know, it's gotta have to be better than Blaziken's Cyclone Kick, maybe, right? Because it's an Ultra Beast and it has, you know, insane special attack coming in at over 173. Now, the rest of the stats don't look that great. Maybe it's gonna have a lot of miss, kind of like Blaziken, but I'm thinking this thing's gonna have to have an insane purple that just knocks Pokemon out. Maybe even better than Flame Gun. Maybe it'll knock out like the nearest 2 Pokemon or 2 Pokemon that are opponents that are adjacent to each other, paralyzing everybody else in its path. You know, I really don't know, but I know it's going to synergize pretty well with Tapu Koko, you know, with getting a plus 30 buff, but I just hope that it's going to have some insane purple. Let me know in the comments, guys, what do you think? I really want to get some discussions going, some theorizing, especially some of you guys that are really knowledgeable about Pokemon and the main series games. But the next Ultra Beast, guys, we have Celesteela. Now, this thing has its EV yield spread out between attack, defense, and special attack. Let's take a look at the biology. I think the most notable part of this whole page, if you skip down to the bottom paragraph, its most distinctive feature is the energy that it stores within itself, a flammable gas that it can shoot from its 2 huge arms. This is mostly used to propel itself in flight and for battle, but it is thought to have a sufficient power and lift to even fly into space. So maybe this is going to be a Pokemon that does return to Ultra Space, and it says despite it being a steel type, it has a plant-like body that can absorb nutrients from the soil. And if we take a look at the base stats, its highest stat is its special attack, but matched pretty closely by its defense and attack. So I don't know. I mean, this Pokemon could have a really awesome wheel. Its speed is pretty low. I don't think it's low enough to make it a 1 MP. Hopefully it's going to be 2 MP, but I have no ideas with this one, guys. You know, this wasn't one of my top picks for one of the best Ultra Beasts that's going to be out there. We have yet to get to them. Zerkatry, I think, may be one of them, but the other three we've yet to cover. But definitely, guys, let me know, what do you think? Is this thing going to have some crazy ability with being able to absorb nutrients from the soil, you know, with having a gas explosion? You know, I don't know. The stats are pretty well balanced, so it could be a really good Pokemon, assuming it's not going to be 1 MP. But then we have Kartana. This is definitely, I think, my favorite Ultra Beast, guys. Who's your favorite Ultra Beast? Let me know in the comments, but I cannot wait to dive into this one. So again, Kartana, this is going to be a grass and steel type. And if you guys haven't noticed too, the abilities Beast Boost, all the Ultra Beasts share this ability, though, you know, the ability in Pokemon Duel may not be, you know, Beast Boost, but it's just something that they have. But this one has a 3 in attack for its EV yield. Let's take a look at the biology and then we'll take a look at the base stats. So basically, Kartana is completely made out of paper, resembling origami. Its arms resemble katanas. Despite its small size compared to the other Ultra Beasts, Kartana is extremely dangerous. As every edge of its body is incredibly sharp, it's able to cut down a gigantic steel tower with one stroke of its blades on its arms. And any opponents that try to attack it will basically be cut to pieces. Its light, paper-like body allows it to evade most attacks by simply floating out of the way, but it also makes it highly vulnerable to fire and water types. So if we take a look at the stats, guys, look at the attack, 181, a 131 for defense, and 109 in speed. I definitely think this is going to have some of the highest damaging white attacks, and it's also probably going to have some gold attacks. I think we could see some crazy abilities, maybe with some mobility, with it being paper-like and being able to just float and evade out of battle. I don't know, and it could definitely have its weaknesses against fire types and water types, since it is, you know, vulnerable to fire and moisture stated in its biology. So, you know, we're seeing this with Beware, with being able to have the battle opponent's damage except for fire types. So I'm really excited to see what this Pokemon's wheel looks like. Guys, again, in the comments, theorize. What do you think it's going to be able to do? I want to know. And then the next Ultra Beast, guys, Guzzlord. Definitely one of the scariest looking Pokemon. I know if I ran into this thing, I would want to be wearing my brown pants 100%. This thing looks awesome. It has 3 in HP, but I don't know. There's going to be a little bit of a drawback, but let's take a look at the biology first. So scroll down on the first paragraph, guys, where you can see what appears to be a pair of large pincers are in fact extensions of its tongue, used to grab and consume anything or anyone nearby. Let's scroll down. About halfway through this bottom paragraph, according to reports, this Pokemon has gobbled up mountains and swallowed buildings whole, and will eat absolutely anything else it can reach, including the very land and sea. Now, although it constantly eats, its droppings have never been found. It's speculated that the entirety of the matter it consumes is converted into energy, with no waste products left over. So I don't know, guys, but what that says to me is banish. Banish exclusions. Like, you get close to this Guzzlord, and if it hits the right attack, and if they give it the ability, again, this is just theorizing, but I could definitely see this consuming a Pokemon, and it's never going to be seen again. Never to be heard of, just completely consumed. Let's take a look at the base stats, though. Okay, so basically, it has high HP in attack, and everything else is pretty low. So I don't think it's going to have any miss. It's probably going to have zero miss. And if you take a look at the speed, it's pretty low. So I could definitely see this being a 1 MP. I don't know. Maybe it's going to be able to consume Pokemon and get additional MP moves. But if they make an Ultra Beast, which is a UX, because the developers know we don't like 1 MP. 1 MP is not good. But if it can banish and maybe be twice as good as Toxapex, it might be worth using. Nobody's going to want to attack into it. But let's take a look at the next Pokemon, and the first Ultra Beast that actually has an evolution. Poiple. It's the purple Poiple. It's pretty funny. But I don't know if this one's going to be a UX or not, guys. It only has a 1 in speed. We can take a look at the biology, but it does have an evolution. It evolves into what I thought was Naganadel, but it says Naganadel. 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 I don't know. So, I mean, they could make this an EX, and then the UX version, the Naganadel, is going to be a UX, but I don't know. It's an Ultra Beast, so it could definitely be a UX. You know, and the stats are pretty low, and, you know, it's pretty balanced, but the total equals 420, which, yeah, I thought was pretty funny. And so, I don't think anybody's going to be using this as a standalone. You can definitely go for an evolution, but, you know, basically the biology was stating that, you know, it has some spikes, it can fire, you know, poison and glow and stuff like that, but I don't think this is anything that we're really going to be using as a standalone figure. We're definitely going to want the evolution, the Naganadel. I don't know why that just sounds so funny to me. Naganadel. Like, Naganadel looks a little bit better, but Naganadel is what they said is how you pronounce it. And this has a 3 in special attack as well. So this is definitely going to be one of my choices for one of the best Ultra Beasts, I think, because special attack is always good. Now, I want you guys to scroll down to the last paragraph. Naganadel's main stinger can eject the powerful adhesive and luminescent poison at a distance of over 6 miles. Okay, so the abdomen contains hundreds of liters of this poison, as well as the Ultra Beast's brain. The stingers on the abdomen are directly connected to its brain, and it will react with violence if they are touched by anyone. So what this screams out to me is attacking from a distance. We've seen it with the common, I can't remember the name of the little bird, but we've seen it most recently in Mega Gallade. Can attack from 2 spaces away, so you might be able to do that with this Pokemon. Now, the speed is 121, but the special attack is its highest attack with 127, so I could definitely see this Pokemon being a 3 MP. Hopefully, they'll give it Soar. I don't know. Maybe. Maybe not. Because it is a dragon type, poison and dragon, but definitely could be a 3 MP special attack. Maybe you can attack from a few spaces away, and since its stinger is connected to the brain, maybe you might even be able to control that Pokemon. I don't know. Theorize in the comments, guys. I want to know what you guys think. And then we have Stakataka. This is going to be a rock and steel type. Now, this Pokemon looks pretty cool, right? But if we take a look at the EV yield, it has 3 in defense. So, again, I don't know, guys. This Pokemon definitely may be a 1 MP. We'll get to the stats, though, but let's take a look at the biology. There's really nothing to note here on what might, you know, lead on to what the wheel might look like, but it's pretty cool that it's made up of 150 life forms. One single Stakataka consists of 150 of these life forms, and then each stone square has a black underside, and then it has blue eyes, but when it's angered, the eyes turn red, so that's pretty cool. So might see some cool animations in battle. So if you take a look at the defense, 211, definitely going to have a ton of blue. Could have some heavy hitting attacks, special defense, so the blue could be doing some amazing things. It may have some amazing white attacks, but the speed, guys. The speed is the lowest we've seen. If Guzzlord's going to be 1 MP, then this guy is definitely going to be 1 MP. So maybe that leaves hope for Guzzlord to still be a 2 MP, but I definitely think this guy's going to be a 1 MP. Again, I don't know how they're going to make a 1 MP viable, even as an Ultra Beast, but it's going to have some pretty insane, you know, blue attacks that are actually going to do things other than just go neutral, like a dodge. The attack's going to have to be really strong. I think Toxapex is probably one of the best 1 MPs that we've seen recently. It's really nice. It synergizes good with a poison deck, and it's tough to attack into. It's tough to kill. So this guy's going to have to be at least twice or 3 times as tough to kill. Now, this is probably my second or third favorite Ultra Beast, probably my second, because I like the Kartana. But we have Blacephalon, and this thing is a fire and ghost type, and the thing looks pretty cool, guys. I cannot wait to dive into it. And if we take a look at its EV yield, This is another one that has a 3 in special attack. So, again guys, I think special attack is really good. I mean, Blaziken has really high special attack, and that Cyclone Kick is one of the best purples in the game. So some of these Ultra Beasts are going to have to be able to top that, in my opinion. Like, they just have to, right? So basically, for a head, Blacephalon has a white ball with a multitude of pink and blue dots that can change color to reflect its emotions. So that might be cool for like different battle animations. But I think the thing to note here, guys, is Blacephalon's head is not attached to its body and can grow or shrink in size when it attacks. Now, Blacephalon is known to trick its targets through the foppish way it walks before blowing its head up without warning in order to steal their vitality. So, the Ultra Beast can freely move its head around easily and regenerate after it blows up. So maybe something kind of like a Voltorb or... yeah, like where you can blow up basically and kill other Pokemon, but maybe he won't be knocked out with it because, you know, he can grow his head back. So why would he be knocked out? Maybe you could attack from a distance with him by throwing your head, blowing up, killing multiple people. I don't know. Again, guys, this thing's going to have to be insane for a UX Ultra Beast and a 151 special attack. And it's got a 127 attack, and the speed is pretty good as well, 107. This could be a 3MP ghost type that can go through other Pokemon, have an insane purple, maybe even a blue. I mean, the defense and HP is pretty low, so it could have some miss, kind of like Blaziken, you know, so it could be vulnerable to other attacks. But I think the attacks that they are going to give it, you know, it's going to have to be good. It's going to have to be good. I think this is going to be one of the best Ultra Beasts, especially if it's a 3MP. It can move through other Pokemon, you know, a fire, ghost type. It's going to be really nice. And, you know, and if people are going to be using that Beware with being able to have damage, I mean, it is a fire type, so it's not going to work on him. And it's a ghost type, so, you know, it should be able to move through other Pokemon. It has insane special attack. Again, I think Blaziken's got one of the best purples with that Cyclone Kick. And we need something better than that. More stars, more power, just, you know, more. It's a UX. It's an Ultra Beast. This thing's insane. It's awesome. Again, guys, theorize in the comments. Talk to each other. Talk to me. Some of you guys, I'm sure, are super knowledgeable and have probably played all the Pokemon main series games. So maybe based off some of the attacks that they have in the main series, based off the biology that we've seen, I could definitely see it throwing its head, though, and like blowing multiple people up, kind of like the flame gun, or maybe even the explosion. But let's take a look at Blaziken, guys. I want to take a look at the stats. Okay, so if we take a look at the EV yield, it has a 3 attack. So let's take a look at the base stats. So for attack, it's got 120, and for special attack, it's got 110. So actually, its attack is higher than the special attack. So if you guys know, I mean, it's got a base 130, which is one of the highest base damage wheels in the game. And then when you evolve it, which is an easy evolution, you have 140, and then it has... you know, that 4-star Cyclone Kick, which is completely insane. You know, it's a 2MP, so the rest of the stats are kind of underwhelming. The HP, defense. So that's why I think it has a little bit more miss on it. But the purple's really good. Its white attack is really good. It even has a gold on there. I mean, its speed is 80. It's a weak gold, but the gold is still a really good gold. Probably one of the best golds, I think, in the game when it actually works. You know, when it actually plays out, like being able to jet kick around is just amazing. So by taking some of this information and looking at the Pokemon that we already have in the game based off the base stats, you know, that's how I'm kind of trying to theorize these Pokemon and why I think maybe saving your material for some of these ones that have yet to come out may definitely be worth it. You know, I'm not sold on Buzzwole, but I wanted you guys to take a look at the base, at the Beast Boost. Basically, what it does is when a Pokemon with Beast Boost directly causes another Pokemon, including allies, to faint by using a damaging move, its highest stat other than HP is increased by one stage. If this stat is already at plus 60, okay, so basically, like, you know, Nihiligo falling in battle, it's going to the Ultra Space, and then other Pokemon are kind of getting a buff from it, like the Buzzwole. Like Pheromosa, you know, with getting the MP, with the Buzzwole getting the increased attack damage. So, you know, I think that's kind of maybe how they're incorporating this Beast Boost ability into the main, from the main series into Pokemon Duel. But again, I don't want to see too many of them going to Ultra Space, but if they make them super strong and make them good enough, and we do have the Faramosa being able to call back other Pokemon, so, you know, Faramosa's not at risk of going to the Ultra Space, so that's good. And I'm kind of under the impression that Nihiligo and Faramosa may be staples in the Ultra Beast deck. You know, depending on whether or not other Pokemon can go to the Ultra Space, maybe the Celestela, maybe, you know, that'll be able to go to the Ultra Space. And Faramosa, you definitely want to be able to call Pokemon back and not be at risk of going to the Ultra Space. But if Nihiligo is going to be the only one going to the Ultra Space, you know, it may be a staple to be able to buff your other types in Faramosa in case both of the Nihiligo get banished. But I wanted you guys to take a look at this. Basically, scientists hypothesize that Cosmog is also an Ultra Beast due to its ability to create Ultra Wormholes. Now, Necrozma, the entry also states that it is a reminiscent of the Ultra Beast, but when it was in the wild, the International Police reported that all Ultra Beasts it had detected had been caught and beat, you know, blah, blah, blah. So this is Necrozma. This is probably going to be one of the like biggest meta-breaking Pokemon I think we're going to see in the game when it finally gets released. Now, don't get too excited. I think we're a little ways away from it. I don't know if we're going to see this until all the other Ultra Beasts have been released. So probably at least a few months away, unfortunately. And now this Pokemon actually has four forms that it can take. And, you know, I don't think there's any other Pokemon that has that many different forms in the game. Now, hopefully, they're not going to be releasing all four forms as different figures. And I don't know if this thing's going to be a UX or not. I hope that it's going to be an EX. And hopefully, they're going to give us the ability to use plates to change its form. But it's kind of a caveat because you do have to have other figures to change its form. And we will get into that. We'll take a look at the stats. We'll kind of see what it looks like. And then we'll kind of take a look at the biology and see, you know, what you need to be able to change its form. So if you take a look at its first base form, it's going to be a psychic type. Then it can be a psychic steel type. Then it can be a psychic ghost type. And then it can be a psychic dragon type. So that's pretty insane. And if you take a look at the EV yields, they're all a little bit different. The top one has one attack, two special attack, then three attack. Then it has three special attack, and then the Ultra Necrozma has one attack, special attack, and one speed. So definitely a big difference between all the different forms. So can you imagine, you know, starting off as the Necrozma, and then the opponent has to really, really think about which form you're going to go into, especially if you have multiple plates, and depending on, you know, what kind of utility, what kind of attacks, you know, having to pick the matchup, because then you could carry multiple plates, and you could turn into any form you want at any time, so they're going to have to really think about which form you could turn into. I don't know, I'm really excited to see this Pokemon. So if you take a look, it says, while it's not known to evolve into or from any Pokemon, it has three other forms. So hopefully the developers of Pokemon Duel don't take this literally, because I want to be able to set an evolution while editing your deck, and then by using a plate, you can change its form. So if you see a fusion with Solgaleo using the end Solarizer. So maybe you could set Solgaleo as the evolution, if you have Solgaleo, and then play the plate, and then you'll be able to go into the Dusk main Necrozma. And then it has the Dawnwing Necrozma, a fusion with Lunala using the N Lunarizer. So again, I hope these are gonna be plates that they introduce, and then you have the Ultra Necrozma, a form obtainable when either Duskmane Necrozma or Dawnwind's Necrozma uses Ultra Burst. Again, hopefully the Ultra Burst is gonna be a plate. So then when you're in either of the other forms, then you can play that plate and then change its form again. So I don't know if this would be a permanent thing or until it's knocked out or how that would work. Again, guys, theories in the comments. How do you think it should be introduced? But I think it's wishful thinking. I could definitely see the developers making this not only four different figures, but then maybe they make it a UX as well. And just the thought of that is disgusting, because, you know, for 5,000 material to be able to craft four, I mean, that's 20K right there. You know, and the odds of pulling it are completely insane. It's just, it's going to be so tough to even pull one of them. I think a lot of us has had pretty good luck on pulling some of the UXs, though. I mean, the odds of pulling a UX with 0.3%, it's pretty low, guys. It's pretty low. But, you know, I think we're a few months away before we see that Pokemon. So the biology, there's really nothing that can indicate what the wheel's going to look like. It's basically just covering what it's going to look like. And, you know, basically just its form, the way it looks, you know, talks about being controlling the Solgaleo or the Lunala when it merges with it. And it has appearances of its true form kind of scattered throughout, looking like armor. And, you know, I guess at the bottom of this here, it says it has a body temperature of 10,000 degrees. And then it can shoot laser beams up to 18 miles away. So again, maybe another Pokemon that can attack from a distance. You know, I think they definitely introduced that in with Mega Gallade as probably the only Pokemon that's useful. I mean, I don't know if it's the Staraptor, the common bird that can attack from a few steps away, but the Mega Gallade's able to, and I think we may see more Pokemon that's able to do that. But if you guys ever want to pause this, or if you guys want to visit any of these sites, you guys can see the web address at the top of the page. You can pause the video, read it, but I'm not going to read through everything. But guys, I hope you guys really enjoyed this video. It definitely took me a while to construct and find everything, and my screen recorder was not wanting to record. It kept crashing. I don't know if you're just not able to record on Safari, so I had to take screenshots and then record the screenshots. But you know, I definitely want to discuss theories in the comments, guys. Leave a like if you guys enjoyed this video. I did have a ton of fun making it, even though it took a while. If you're new to the channel, definitely subscribe, leave a like, and hit that notification bell so you don't miss my next video. Follow me on Twitter if you haven't already. And until the next one, later, guys.